Good evening, everyone, or good morning, good afternoon, wherever you are. Welcome to the Zen and Zazen class. Last week I was away from Osaka. I gave a talk in Kamakura. I spent the night in Kamakura, so I wasn't here. But tonight we will meditate together again, and I want to say a few words about another Chinese koan. But before we get to the Zen story, let's sit for half an hour together.
我们前面还是先做30分钟，然后后面再一起讨论一个公案。今天讨论那个公案是从中国来的一个公案。
So as always, I start with swinging the upper body left and right. First, bigger movements, gradually getting smaller and smaller. And that can help to lower the, how do you say, the center. Often we live our daily lives up here in the head. And during Zazen, it's better to lower your center and once you build the base of the posture with the knees and the buttocks, allow your spine and your neck to stretch. You lower your eyes a little bit, relax the shoulders, and try to just be aware of what is actually happening during these 30 minutes rather than play the game up in your head.
在做之前大家可以左右晃一晃啊，从大到小左右晃一晃，然后找到你的重心，把你的体重往下放，然后关注到正在发生的事情，关注到自己的呼吸，不要胡思乱想的时候也没关系啊，关注到现在正在发生的事情。
Okay, let's start today's Zazen. Thank you, everybody. It seems that my internet connection is not very stable today. I think I disappeared from your screens 2 times. I hope that we can stay connected for the rest of the time. Today I want to talk about a saying by the Chinese monk Zhoshu. We encounter Zhoshu already, for example, in that famous koan. His teacher Nansen cuts a cat, and later, after he returns to the monastery in the evening, when he hears about that, he puts his straw sandals on his head. That was Zhoshu. Also, Zhoshu is the one when a monk asked him, does a dog also have Buddha nature? Zhoshu answered, muh. So nothing or no.
我们今天分享一个关于赵州和尚、赵州禅师的一个故事。之前我们其实分享过了，就是那个斩猫的那个故事，南拳斩猫。最后赵州不是把那个鞋放在头上吗？就是那个禅师。然后还有人问过赵州狗有没有佛性，然后赵州禅师他的回答就是汪叫了一声，什么也没有。今天我们分享他的一个公案。
And the phrase I want to talk today is in Japanese, you read it kisako, which means something like please have a cup of tea.
我们今天分享这个叫沏茶去，然后日语的翻译呢是去喝茶，但中文是不是是做茶的意思？日语里面是那个喝茶的意思。我们去喝茶。
And the story goes as follows. Whenever somebody came to visit Zhoshu, Zhoshu would first ask him, have you been here before? Or is it your first time? And you can interpret this question, have you been here before, in several ways. One common sense question would be, well, is this your first time at this monastery? Is it the first time that we meet? But you can also interpret it as the here, meaning the place of, how do you say, existence, the here and now. So you could also understand the question as, do you know what I'm talking about when I say here and now? Or do you don't know yet what the here and now is?
有人去拜访赵州的时候呢，他总是问别人一个问题，就是你来过这儿吗？这句话有两个含义，一个是你是第一次来这个寺庙吗？或者是我们是第一次见面吗？然后还有一个意思就是我说的这儿指的是这个地方和现在，也就是说你能不能听懂我说话啊？你能不能明白我现在说的这儿和那儿是什么意思？
Anyway, Zhoshu would ask a monk that came, have you been here before? And the monk says, no, this is my first time, I've never been here. And Zhoshu says in Japanese, kisako, so please have a cup of tea then. And then a second monk comes and Zhoshu asks the same question, have you been here before? And the monk says, yes, I have been here. And Zhoshu says, okay, please have a cup of tea then.
然后如果有人来，他问这个问题，你来过这儿吗？如果这个人回答，我没有来过这儿。然后赵州的回答是，那好，我们去喝杯茶吧。然后下一个人呢，来了之后就，赵州也是同样一个问题。当这人回答说，我来过这儿。然后赵州的回答还是一样的，那走，我们去一起喝茶吧。
And one of the students of Zhoshu thought that's strange. Why would he serve a cup of tea to the one who says he's never been here? But the other monk who says he's already been here, he also serves him a cup of tea. So he asked Zhoshu, why? Why do you serve the first monk tea, but you also serve the second monk tea? And Zhoshu responded by saying, please have a cup of tea.
然后他有一个学生就感到很奇怪，就问赵州，那为什么那个大家回答来过或者是有和没有，你都说我们去喝杯茶呢？然后赵州的回答是，那好吧，我们去喝杯茶吧，还是这句话。
I came across this only a couple of days ago on Twitter, but it seems it's already a couple of years ago. I want to share this with you. It's Boris Johnson 4 years ago or so, I think. Maybe this is
Do you
what
apologize for what you
Joe
did? Do you
should
apologize? Do you have a cup?
try to do.
Apologize for your
Would you
comments.
like a cup of tea?
Yeah,
Keep
sure.
going. Have a cup of tea.
Thank you, thank you. Do you regret what do you
I'll show it once more from the
Do you
beginning.
apologize for what you for your comments?
Would you have a cup of tea?
Will you apologize for your
Would you
comments?
like a cup of tea?
Yeah,
Keep
sure.
going. Have a cup of tea.
Thank you, thank you. Do you regret what
Would you like a cup of
do you regret your comments? Do
Take
you
one
regret your
of
comments?
them. Go and have a cup of tea.
Thank you very
There
much.
you go.
Sir.
There you go.
Do you regret your
Yeah.
comments, sir?
I want you to have a cup of tea.
If I have a
Keep
cup
going.
of tea, will you answer my
No,
question?
I'm here solely on a humanitarian mission because you've been here all day and you've been incredibly patient and incredibly, and I feel very sorry for you because I have nothing to say about this matter except offer you some tea.
Okay.
Okay?
No,
Go on.
Okay, thank you.
Who's got a
Thank you so
spare hand?
much.
Go on.
Okay, so that was Boris Johnson serving some reporters who had been waiting all day to ask him a question. A cup of tea. And well, maybe what he's doing there is kind of similar to what Joshua is doing. Why don't you have a cup of tea?
刚才我们看的那个影片是4年前的一个就是节目，那些记者在外边等了一天，就是想去采访刚才那个人哈，然后他回答只有一句话：“我们来喝杯茶吧，我们来喝杯茶吧。”然后他说：“你们在这等了一天，我也没有什么可回答大家的，就是我唯一能说的就是我们来喝一杯茶吧。”其实这个人他的回答就是和赵州有点类似哈，他是不是在效仿赵州这个做法？其实是一样的。
And before we start with the question session, maybe I want to relate a different story. I think 2 or 3 weeks ago, I was talking about Sen no Rikyu, the Japanese founder of tea ceremony, who also is credited for the saying Ichigo Ichie, so a kind of one lifetime encounter. So he is called the founder of Japanese traditional tea ceremony, and his son was also a tea master. And one day, Sen no Rikyu's son, his name I think was Doan. Doan was inviting his father to participate in a tea ceremony, and he had built a tea house and a nice garden around that tea house. And Sen no Rikyu with the other guests came to participate in that tea ceremony.
就是我们之前分享那个一期一会，一期一会是从日本来的。然后这句话是一个茶道的大师，他首先说出来的。然后这个茶道大师的儿子呢，也是一个茶道大师。然后他有一次邀请他的父亲去参加一个很有名的一个就是茶的一个会，茶会，
And maybe you have seen these Japanese Zen gardens that you often find around these tea houses. So they have lots of rocks arranged in a very special way, and there's moss growing. And you have what is called in Japanese tobi-ishi. Those are kind of like stones that you can step on if you want to cross the garden. And when Sen no Rikyu, so Doan's father, was crossing the garden, he realized that one of these stones was just a little bit too high. I think maybe just a few millimeters from his perception. Oh, this stone is just a few millimeters too high.
然后他的这个父亲去参加茶会的时候，因为日本的那个禅寺、禅院，大家不知道见没见过哈？它都是好多树啊，然后好多石头啊，所以大家都是踩着那个石头去进入到那个 就是那个房间里边，当他父亲踩着那个石头进入到那个茶会的房间的时候呢，发现有一个石头稍微高那么一点点，比其他石头高一点点。
And so when he took off his shoes and entered the hut, he would say to the other guests before he met his son, I just realized that my son still needs some training because maybe the rest of you hasn't noticed, but one of these stones was just a few millimeters too high. And his son, he heard it from the other side of the paper screen. And when his son heard it, he said, oh, my father is smarter than I thought. Of course, I'd realized that stone is just a little bit too high, but I thought that nobody would notice it. But after all, my father noticed that the stone is just a little too high. So when everybody was drinking tea, the son was sneaking out to the garden and he was digging a little bit under the stone so that it got deeper. And after the tea ceremony was over and everybody left, the other guests didn't notice that anything has changed, but Senno Likyu noticed, oh, my son must have heard me. My son heard that I was commenting on the stone and now he fixed it. And he would say it to the other guests. Because I said something, see, he made the stone a little bit deeper.
然后当这个大师他进入到就是这个那个房间的时候，脱完鞋之后，他跟这些宾客说啊，我知道我的儿子可能还需要一些练习，因为你们看外面有一个石阶比别的石阶稍微高一点点，可能我的儿子还是需要一些修炼。然后他的儿子其实听到了，他就是在屏风后面，在别的屋，其实他听到了，然后那个茶会就开始了。在大家喝茶的时候呢，他儿子偷偷到外面去，把那个从那个石头下面，就是往下面刨了一点那个土，然后把那个石头石头给垫平了。然后等到结束的时候呢，那个大家都出来的时候，他没有人，其实进来的时候也没有人注意到那个小石头高一点，但是走的时候也没有人注意到那个小石头高了一点哈。然后他的父亲，可是只有他的父亲注意到了，就是那个石头，你看，哦，原来我的儿子刚才听到了我跟大家说话有一个石阶高一点，他听到了，他刚刚悄悄的把那个又修补过来了。然后他现在又告诉大家，哦，我刚才原来我儿子刚才注意到了，听到了我说话，他把这个又修好了。
D.T. Suzuki, or in Japanese is called Suzuki Daisetsu, he relates in a book called Zen and Japanese Culture. He relates this story and he uses it as an example how mindful tea masters like Senno Likyu or his son Doan were, and that they were noticing very small kind of details that nobody else would notice. But when I read the story in the book by D.T. Suzuki, I was thinking, why couldn't they just have a cup of tea? Why do they need to play their game even in the world of tea ceremony? Senno Likyu, if he was so, how do you say, if he cared about the stone rather than telling the other guests, hey, look, that stone is a little bit too high, he could have fixed it himself. Or if he thought it's not so important to fix it, he could have just kept silent. On the other hand, if his son realized that the stone is too high, why didn't he fix it before? Why did he only go out after he heard his father comment on it? And then if the father realized after the tea ceremony that his son had secretly fixed it, why again did he have to tell everybody, hey, I noticed. It's only because I commended it that my son fixed it. So I'm a little bit surprised that even famous tea masters like Zen Lo Likyu still play this game. Hey, hey, I'm more mindful than you. I'm more mindful than you. And maybe when Joshu said, please have a cup of tea, he also meant forget about your Zen practice, forget about your enlightenment, forget about your mindfulness. Just taste this tea here.
日本有一个就是大师铃木大师，他写了好多关于禅的书，就是介绍禅的书。然后他里面其实就讲过好多 mindful 怎么翻译，就是精神很集中、很注意的这些人呢，他特别注意细节，他会注意到别人看不到的一些小细节。然后但是幕后老师他在知道这个故事，然后或者是看到铃木大师他那本书之后呢，他有一个想法，就是为什么？他们不好好喝茶，为什么要玩这个游戏？你看，就是他那个儿子，其实他是知道的，院子里面有一个石头稍微高出一点点，他为什么不提前把他自己修好呢？他既然知道，他为什么不修呢？而且要等到他的父亲说完之后他再修。然后为什么他的父亲注意到了，同样的，为什么他父亲注意到这个石头高一点，他要说出来呢？如果他觉得很重要的话，他为什么不自己把它修好呢？还要告诉大家，你看我比你们更有就是更有意识，然后更我因为好像只有我注意到了这个石头稍微高一点。同样的，在他们结束的时候，为什么他还要告诉大家，你看还是我比大家更有意识，我也注意到这个石头修好了。就是同样的，这么大的大师，这么意识集中的这些就是茶道的大师们，他们是很就是禅修哈，很高级这些人，但是他也一直在玩这个游戏，就是我比你强，我能意识到你没有意识到这个游戏呢。他们为什么不就好好的来吧，我们去喝杯茶吧，就像那个我们今天分享那个故事赵州禅师说的那样，走，我们去喝杯茶，为什么不这样呢？
So I want to stop talking here and invite you to have a cup of tea, or if you would prefer to ask questions, you can also ask a question or comment if you have your own opinion. Please don't hesitate.
大家有问题可以提啊，今天分享就先到这儿，有问题可以提。
Okay, Chris is already helping himself and Xuan to tea. Great. Yeah, Liat, you're raising your hand, please.
What I heard is that from your story, what I heard now from your story is that Joshua is Joshua, and I cannot pronounce the other one who makes the tea ceremony. I'm sorry. Could you help me? What's his name?
Zen Lo Likyu.
Zen Lo Likyu. Sorry, yes. So he is himself, and his son is himself. So I heard that you think to yourself, why don't they have a tea? But I think they are not Joshua. They are Zen Lo Likyu. Sorry for mispronouncing.
Yes. Yeah.
I think this is their way of. This is their way, and
maybe they just enjoyed playing this game with each other, and that was their way to entertain themselves. It's possible.
Also, I think about your sentence a lot about stopping the game, and I ask myself, what is my game? Like, I don't play the game, but what is the game that I do play? And then I would like to stop it or to see what the game is, you know? But I think it's not a name for all the, it's my game.
Yes.
And I noticed it that I was walking in the street and I was thinking something and I said, this is your game. This is
We are playing all games most of the time, And most of the time we don't even realize it's a game. Hmm.
刚才这个朋友他就是说他觉得赵州是赵州，然后那个大师查到大师是大师，他的儿子是儿子，他们不是一个人，所以他们有不同的看法。然后那个老师说那可能他们就是一直很就是很 enjoy 很喜欢这个游戏，他们可能在玩这个游戏，很喜欢这个游戏。然后刚才那个朋友又说那老师一直在说要停止玩这个游戏，停止玩这个游戏，那我就在思考我的游戏是什么呢。他就一直在找自己这个游戏。有一天他突然想过来，原来他在走路的时候就觉悟过来，其实我一直在想这个游戏是什么，我就一直在玩这个游戏。
Do you have any other questions?Anything you would like to commence? Ah, Chiak-san, please.
Hello.
Hello.
This story of Senno Rikyu and his son, I've heard from you a couple of times, and each time, my impression is very typical.Story of father and son. Senno Rikyu is a great tea master, but as long as he's a father, he cannot stop to play a game as a father of a son. And I felt a bit sorry to hear this story because the expectation of father.To son is mostly so high, and I have two elderly brothers, and they had such a difficulties with our father. So maybe Senno Rikyu had a peace in tea ceremony, but out of the tea ceremony, he couldn't stop being just a.Ordinary human being and as an ordinary father. That's what I cannot stop hearing each time I listen to the story. As I want to share with you. Thank you.
Yeah, I get the same impression. Like maybe they just both enjoyed the game, but I also get this impression that even Senno Rikyu, in this case, wanted to kind of show everybody here. I still can do it better than my son. And the son wanted to prove, oh, no. I also knew it. It's just that I didn't think that my father would realize. So who knows? DT Suzuki seems to think that the story shows that both the father and the son were very mindful and were really very aware. But if that's the case, why did they need to play this game with each other? But who knows? So you can all have each a cup of tea and think about it by yourself, or think about, as Liat say, what is my game? Maybe I'm also playing a game. What's the game that I'm playing? And having a cup of tea is an opportunity to just stop the game for 5 minutes or so, take a break from the game for 5 minutes. I think that's what Joshu says. So it's not really about have you been here before or have you not been here before. Are you enlightened already, or do you try to get enlightened in the future? It's quitting the game means to also stop that game. I'm already enlightened. I'm not yet enlightened. It means to just take a break from that game and taste the tea. And taste the tea can also be just watch the breath you're taking right now. Listen to the birds that you hear sing outside the window.
然后刚才那个朋友呢，他说他其实听了幕后老师讲这个故事好几次了，他每次听这个故事的时候呢，他都不能停下来，就是想，其实在作为一个茶道大师以外，他还是一位父亲，当他看到他儿子的时候，他可能停不下来要去纠正他的就是他的儿子的错误。作为一个父亲，他可能停不下来，然后他也想到他有两个哥哥跟他的父亲的关系，他每次听到这个小故事的时候都想到了是这个啊，就是可能在这个茶道这个仪式以外，他有他别的游戏，他这个角色停不下来。然后呢，老师说确实是像之前那个铃木大师，就是日本一个禅学的一个大师哈，他在分享这个故事的时候是想跟大家说，这两个人都是特别有意识的人，就是他们两个都是茶道很高端的这个很境界的这些大师。但是幕后老师他的想法是，他们其实还是那个停不下来这个游戏。不，其实不在于，就像赵州讲的哈，不在于你来过还是没来过，不在于这个问题，而在于也不在于你没有达到，就像也没有达到禅定的境界，而在于其实你要从这个游戏当中停下来，要停止去想这个问题，要从这个游戏当中怎么说呢，休息一下。好好喝杯茶，然后关注于你的呼吸，关注于现在外边的鸟儿是不是在叫，其实这些才是重要的。
Any other questions? Anything else you want to share? We are approaching 9 here in Japan, so...Well, it's officially a good time to end this class. We will see each other next week if you want to join again. Next week, I'm going to talk about Sawaki Roshi's sayings again. Shuen-san, will you join us from Kyushu next week or good?
Yeah, next week I can join the class.
good. So have a nice week, and I hope to see you again. Thank you for participating.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.